Okay, next one. The last one, what's on the test? So we know that there are mainly two sections. The first one is evidence-based reading and writing. Do you know what is there in evidence-based reading and writing? What they're exactly asking that? Anyone? What exactly they will ask in evidence-based reading and writing? Yes, passages, then?
Forms.
Okay, then? Okay, write down what exactly they will ask in SAT. So, passage-based reading and passage-based grammar. Passage-based reading and passage-based grammar. Okay. Next, math. So, what type of question or what topic you can expect in math section? Anyone? Algebra, as I told you earlier, it's a more of algebra. The first topic you can get in math. This one is algebra. Write down algebra. Then, apart from algebra, only algebra we can get? Trigonometry. Basic trigonometry. Algebra, basic trigonometry, then? Okay, then we come. Okay, so probability, data analysis, algebra, trigonometry, data analysis, and advanced math. Algebra, data analysis, trigonometry, advanced math, and geometry. Geometry is a minor topic this time. Okay, last time it was a major topic, but this time it is a minor one. So, very basic question you can expect from geometry. Okay, next, optional essay. Write down in the place of optional essay, passage and analysis. So, you are going to get passages and you need to analyze them. Passage and analysis will be there in essay part. Passage in essays. Sorry, passage in analysis. Done? Okay, now I have a question. So that is there in the next page. How beautiful is the SAT? What do you think about that? How much beautiful is the SAT? 100%? No, they are asking exactly, is this easy or the medium or the difficult one?
Well, once you know how it goes, then it's easy.
Yes. So, how beatable is the SAT means? It is very well beatable. Write down, very well beatable. But, with the techniques. Very well beatable with the TPR techniques. You have to learn TPR. TPR means not for instant review. So, we have our own techniques. From that, it is very much beatable. TPR, differential review. Okay, do you know how many times it is administered SAT in a year?
Four.
Six times
in India, 7 times in abroad. The new SAT, 6 times in India and 7 times in abroad. Okay. Then how many times can you take the SAT?
Twice.
N number of times you can take the SAT, but suggestible is at the max by 2 attempts you should get a good score. Okay? You should not take again and again because it will be a bad impression, because universities will come to know how many times you have taken the SAT, what score you have got, all those things. So at the max you should attempt twice and get the scores by the second attempt. Okay? So the answer for that is n number of times, but you have to attempt maximum 2 times. Maximum I'm telling you. Okay, when you will take the SAT?
When all is it there? When all is it
October? Tell me when all it happens?
May.
The SAT?
October, December.
October, December.
May.
Then?
Jan.
Okay, write down all of you there. In the second one only. When is the SAP administered? No, there. Jan. Jan, March. Second question is there, no? When is the SAP administered? There only you can write down. How many? Jan, March, May, June, not July, June, October, November, December. That is in US it is 7, in India March is
1.
Okay. Yes. Next. We know the structure of the SAP. Let's go in detail about this. Number of questions, how many number of questions I will get, and how much time I will get for each section.
Interval also there.
Yeah, yeah.
We postpone it to 4 o'clock.
What happened? Okay. So next is structure of the SAP. Evidence-based reading and writing. So you will have two sections in that, reading and writing. So in reading, number of passages. Anyone know how many passages you will have? 5 passages you will have. Reading 5 passages. And number of questions 52. 5-2. And a pencil. Yes, time is 65 minutes. Number of passages 5. And number of questions 52. And time is 65 minutes. Then the second one, writing in language, how many passages? 4 passages you will have. 44 now. Number of questions 44. And 35 minutes. Yes. Okay. So I will ask question on this. There will be a quiz after the session. So you should remember the number of questions and structure of the SAP carefully. Okay, so last at the end of the session, I'm going to ask you the questions. Next, math. No calculator section and calculator section. In no calculator, first types of question you will have two types of question: multiple choice and grading. Multiple choice means what? So you will have options. In that, you need to pick one right answer. Do you know how many options you will have?
Four.
Yes, exactly four. There were 5 options in previous SAT. Now they have reduced it to 4 options. So, write down in the no calculator section, multiple choice 15 you will have. 15. And grading, what do you mean by grading questions? Do you know? Yes, some SAT questions they won't provide the options. You need to enter the answer in the box provided. Okay, that is that type of question we call it as grading. So, 5 grading you will have in no calculator section. And one more new type of question they have introduced, extended thinking. So in no calculator section, there will be no any extended thinking questions. So, what do you mean by extended thinking? Anyone know? Yes, extended thinking means you have to think beyond what they have given the data. So that will be called as extended thinking. You need to extend your thinking to answer those kind of questions. Okay, so for example, they will give some experiment, some survey they will give. So based on the survey, how they have done, you need to come to a conclusion. Okay, so and options will be there. So in the option, you have to tell which conclusion is best supported by the data. So those kind of questions we call it as extended thinking. So in no calculator, there will be no extended thinking questions. And the time allotted for no calculator is 25 minutes. 25 minutes. Now come to the calculator section. Number of multiple choice questions are 30. And grading questions are 8. And extended thinking questions are 2. Actually these 2 questions are out of those 8 grading questions only. So 8 grading questions out of 8, 2 are extended thinking. That's why total number of questions are 38 only. And time allotted for the calculator section question is 55 minutes. 5-5. So this is about math part. Okay, next essay. Topic is passage based analysis. Topic is 5-0. Is that clear? So this is the structure of SAP. So go to next page.
Okay.
15 minutes, 5-0. Okay, go to next page. There are few notes which are very important for the SAT structure. Do you know how many hours is the SAT exam?
Four hours.
4 hours, exactly.
4 hours.
So the first one, yes, can you read the first one? First note?
Total time, 3 hours, 15 minutes with SA.
So with SA, it is 3 hours, 15 minutes. Okay? So the without SA?
3 hours.
3 hours. But you should take the SA, which is very important. Even though it is optional. Okay? So can you read the second point? So already we know that multiple choice questions will have 4 answer choices. Okay, the third one, Vignesh, can you read? 2 Vignesh, no?
Okay.
Initial. What is your initial?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, Vignesh, yes, you tell. Third point. So there is no penalty. Last time there was a penalty for the wrong answer, 1/4 it was. But this time there is no penalty. That's why you should not leave any question unanswered. Okay, you should be very careful. At last minute, if you don't know anything, then mark it by guessing. Okay, you should not leave any question unanswered. You should mark it by guessing. So when I say guessing, there are few techniques to guess your answers also that I am going to discuss in the first class. So how to guess my answer in the last minute. Clear? Okay, the third one, who's going to read? Yes, can you read next fourth one?
Questions are easy, medium or hard and each work or hard.
Okay, so questions are easy, medium or hard. So three types of questions you are going to get, easy, medium and hard questions. Okay, and each will be 1 point. Okay, next, who is going to read the next one? Akshay. Next point. So what does it mean, questions in math are not out of difficulty means? So these are what are difficulty means? Yes? So yeah, so easy, medium and difficult are, it's not in order, okay? So you can find easy, next, medium, or you can find easy first, next, difficult, those kind of questions will be there. In manual, first three chapter, we have written, for easy question we have written like E, and medium question we have like, you know, represented M and difficult question B, so that you can identify how easy questions will be, how the medium and how the difficult questions. After third chapter, you should be able to recognize which is an easy question and which is a medium and which is a hard question for you. Okay? Yes. Next one. Who is going to read the next one? Yes. The last point.
Questions in reading and writing are not in order.
So in reading and writing, it is not in the order of difficulty. So once you start with the verbal part, no, you will come to know how these type of difficulty level varies. Is that clear? Okay, now already we discussed this, how is the SAT score. We just have to fill. So I am going to ask